गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन ऑफ एकेडमिक वर्ल्ड स्कूल बेमेतरा। दिस इज माय सेकंड लेक्चर ऑन दिस चैप्टर डिटरमिनेंट्स। लास्ट टाइम वी अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डिटरमिनेंट। टुडे इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन properties associated with determinant. The sole purpose of learning these properties is to acquire the skills to solve the problems of determinants. You will notice that after understanding all these properties, for you solving determinants will become little easy. It helps a lot, and therefore we need to understand each and every property. So what I will do in this class, I'll explain all these properties, and then after finishing these properties we will take up some questions and then see to it that by using these properties the approach becomes very simplified. It becomes very simple to solve the questions. So let's begin. In these properties, it varies from book to book. In some textbook you will see that there are only 6 properties which are mentioned. In some of the books, reference book, you will see that there are 7 properties are mentioned over there. In some cases you may find little more also, but I am going by this NCERT. Look at this. The very first property is named as reflection property. I am going to explain all these. So first let me very quickly brief you what are the properties which we are going to learn. Reflection property, all zero property, switching property, scalar multiple property, then comes proportionality property, invariance property, and then the last one which is mentioned over here is sum property. Now we need to understand what does it mean in the context of determinants. So one by one we are going to take up. This is for your reference. Let's say we are taking a determinant a1 b1 c1 a2 b2 c2 a3 b3 c3. These are the elements. You have learned in the previous class how to expand determinant to find the value of it. So we have expanded it about first row. So how we expand? Let's say if we are expanding about first row, then what do we do? That element, and then what we write? We leave the row and the column in which it belongs, and then whatever is left, write down that. Then minus sign. How come this minus has come? Because we write minus 1 to the power I plus j. This I and j, it stands for the location of that element. This element belongs to first row, second column. I becomes 1, j becomes 2, so I plus j becomes 3, and therefore it will be minus. That is how this minus sign has come. So leave this element, this column, this row, these two are left, so it is written. Similarly take this one c1, so leave these. This part is left, this part has taken, and then if you expand, you will get this one. Now, when we say we are taking this property, reflection property, property number 1, we are taking this. Reflection property means, if you are given any matrix A is any matrix. Let's say this is written Aij of order m cross m. What I have done? I have taken a square matrix of order m, and then I have taken transpose of this. So what will be transpose? It will become Aji and then m cross n. That will remain same. This is a given matrix, and then this is the transpose of this matrix. Now, this property says that if you take the corresponding determinant of that, determinant corresponding to this matrix and determinant corresponding to this element, this matrix, that will be transpose of that. It says, this property says that both will remain same. What does it mean? If you are given any determinant, if you interchange rows by column, rows are converted into column, obviously column will be converted into row, then the value of determinant doesn't change, it remains same. It's very important property, and when we are going to solve question, we will be using it. Let's move to the second property. What is the second property? Second property says all zero property. All zero property means, let's say if you are given this determinant A, it is given A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. This is given. All zero property means, in any determinant, if all elements of any row or column, all elements of any row or column becomes zero, then the value of determinant will be zero. For example, let's say all elements, these elements are converted into zero. Just imagine, if all these three are zero, look at this, this is the same one. So you have expanded this. A1 is zero, B1 is zero, C1 is zero, zero multiplied by anything, zero multiplied by something, zero multiplied by something, this whole thing will remain zero, and hence this value becomes zero. That is what is the property, and therefore you need to understand that if all elements of any row or column of a determinant becomes zero, then the value of determinant is zero. Let's move to the third property. Switching property. What is switching property? So obviously name says switching. Switching property means we are going to switch something. So understand, in this case, what happens? In this third property, simply switching means, if we take, suppose, determinant A as A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3, if we take this, please understand, this is the determinant, given determinant. You can say, let's say this is determinant D, delta, fine? And now, what we are doing, there is another determinant given, delta 1. What is given in that? In that, we are given A1, B1, C1, A3, B3, C3, A2, B2, C2. Please understand. What is the change in this? The last two rows are interchanged. They are switched. They are interchanged. So whenever two rows or two columns are interchanged, in that case, what happens? Delta is equal to, value of determinant doesn't change, but its sign changes. Please understand. Its sign changes. The value, suppose its value is minus, its value is 5. Then if you interchange any two rows or any two column, its value will become minus 5. Only sign of the determinant will change. by changing two rows or two columns. Now let's move to property 4. What is this property 4? It says that this fourth property says, it's given a scalar multiple property. Scalar multiple property. If you are given, let's say determinant A is given by A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. It says that if you multiply by a constant to all elements of any specific row or column, by the same scalar you have to multiply to the determinant. What does it mean? It means, let's say I multiply very first this row by k. So k A1, k B1, k B1, k C1, A2 B2 C2, A3 B3 C3. Let's say we have multiplied. Are you getting that? Now try to understand. Its expansion is written this one. This is the expansion. If I expand this, where changes will come? Let's say I am expanding about first row. About first row, if I expand, please understand what we have done. We have multiplied all elements of first row by constant k. Now, by this, what changes will come? Look at this. In place of A, you will have k A1, k B1, k C1. So from all these three brackets, k will be common. So can we say that in this case, if I multiply by k, k will be common. So if I multiply by this, this is nothing but it becomes k times delta. If I say that this is my delta 1. Why delta 1? Because I have multiplied. This is a new matrix, new determinant. So for this, what will be value of this? What is the difference between these two? This is simply written A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. Just simply it is written. And what is written here? Simply we have multiplied first row's element by constant k. Now we want to see what is the relationship between these two. So the relationship is k times delta. The determinant gets multiplied by the same constant. Let's move to the next property. We have done this. Proportionality property. This property is very important property. In this property you need to, they are more or less same, but it depends upon how we are using it. Look at this. In this case, let's say there is, we are given this delta as A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. Now, please understand. This proportionality means what? There is a row in which elements are proportional to any other row's element, or there is a column in which elements of this column are proportional to the elements of some other column. Understand what does it mean? It means, let's say we can say A3 is nothing but k times A1, B3 is k times B1, C3 is nothing but k times C1. Elements of this third row, they are proportional to the elements of first row. What does it mean? It means this delta can be rewritten as A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2,
k times k1, k times b1, k times c1.
Please understand. Now you can see that these elements of third row, they are proportional to that. You can take k common from this side. Then what will happen? First row and third row will become same, identical. Whenever in a determinant two rows are same or two columns are same, the value of determinant becomes zero. Once again, I am reminding you, whenever you notice that there are two rows or two columns in a determinant are exactly same, you need not to look for anything else. The value of determinant becomes zero. Now, let's move to this sixth property, which is a very, very important property. This we will be using very frequently, very frequently. Let's see that. As per this property, it says invariance property. Invariance, whatever we do, there are some steps when we apply, the value of determinant remains unchanged. It doesn't change. It doesn't vary. It remains invariant. Please understand. So, what is it that we do and the value of determinant doesn't change? We need to understand that. Let's say we are given delta as a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a3, b3, c3. Now we are making some change. Let's say we are making change in c1. Please understand. In C1 means in first column we are making some change. What is the change we are making? In C1 the change we are bringing is, we are adding in C1 alpha time of C2 plus beta time of C2. I hope you are understanding. In column 1, first column, we are adding corresponding elements of column 2 alpha times. Similarly, we are adding beta times corresponding element of column 3 in C1. So then what will happen?
You can see delta will become A1 plus, as per this, alpha b1 plus beta c1, a2 plus alpha b2 plus beta c2, a3 plus alpha b3, alpha b3 plus beta c3, and then b1 c1, b2 c2, b3 c3. This
remains as it is. So there is a change. What is the change? Column C is now changed. What is that change? The change we have brought as per this. In column C1, we have added corresponding elements of C2 alpha times and beta times element of corresponding element of column 3. In C1's element, we have added that. Now, this property says that if you do this, then the value of this doesn't change. It remains what was given. If it is a delta, it remains a delta. I hope you are understanding. This we will be utilizing when we are doing sums, problems. We will use, and remember that this property is heavily used. There are many occasions where you will see that we will be using very frequently this property. Therefore, we become expert of this here. Now come to the last property, that is the seventh property. Let's see the seventh property. This seventh property says, it is called as sum property. What does it mean, sum property? It may happen that the determinant which is given, in that determinant, the elements of any specific row or column are presented as a sum of two elements. For example, let's say the delta what is given like this, A1 plus K1, B1 plus K2, C1 plus K3, then A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. Please understand. In this, what we are discussing? We are discussing sum property. What is sum property? It says that in a given determinant, let's say if elements of any specific row or column are presented as sum of two elements. For example, in this determinant, elements of first row are presented as A1 plus K1, B1 plus K2, C1 plus K3. If such situation comes, then property says that we can split this determinant in two determinants. How? It can be rewritten as A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3, plus second determinant when you are writing, then first row will become the elements which are added to that. It will become K1, K2, K3, then A2, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3. Check that. This is called as sum property. What is sum property? Indeterminate, if elements of any row or column are presented as a sum of two elements, then the determinant can be split in two parts. As you can see that over here, these elements of first row are given as a sum of two elements. So what we have done, we have segregated these two. Remember that, it's a very important property. Fine. So these are the seven properties which are given in your textbook, and we need to learn all these. Now question is, where and how we can utilize these properties? What is the significance of these properties? Obviously, this question will emerge to your mind after putting so much effort, how it can benefit us. So let's see that. I am going to take up some question where we are going to use these properties. Fine, let's see that. So we will take up some questions and then see that how to solve it. Before I take up any question, let me remind you one thing. Before, when you begin, read the instruction very carefully, because at times there might be something which is hidden in instruction itself. For example, I am writing one question. It says, prove that, the question is, it says, prove that what we have to prove? Look at this. A minus B, B minus C, C minus A, then second row is B minus C, C minus A, A minus B, and then C minus A minus B, and then B minus C is equal to 0. Question says, prove this is equal to 0, and in bracket it is written without expanding. Prove this without expanding. This is how you need to look into the question. Is there any hidden condition is applied? Now, the moment you come to know that, expanding means what? You can decide any row or any column along that row or column you can expand. But here that restriction is given. Restriction says you cannot expand. What does it mean? It means you have to use these properties, and these properties are very, very useful. We are going to use these properties. Now look at this. What we are going to do? You learn that invariance property. I said that invariance property is very, very important. I am going to use this property. Look at this. In this question, how to begin? First, write down the question. So I am writing left hand side. What is your left hand side? First, mention that A minus B, B minus C, C minus A, B minus C, C minus A, A minus B, and then comes C minus A, A minus B, B minus C. I have noted down my left hand side. Now, after this, what I am going to do? I am going to, please see that. This is what I am going to do. In R1, this is the way you have to write. The changes which I am going to bring. The R1, this row R1, I am going to change. How I am going to change? There is a change in R1. Simply R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the change I am bringing. What does it mean? Corresponding elements of R2 and R3, these elements we are going to add to corresponding element of row 1. Means these two will be added to this, these two will be added to this, these two will be added to this. Only this much we have to do. And then the other two will remain same. Let's see what happens if we do that. So we are adding this. Look at this. What will happen if we add this? So my first row will become A minus B. It will become A minus B plus B minus C plus C minus A. This is my first element. Then I am taking B minus C plus C minus A plus A minus B. This is the second element of first row. Then coming to C minus A plus A minus B plus, and then I have added all these. Now write down your second and third row. So third, second row will be B minus C, C minus A, A minus B, and last row is C minus A, A minus B, B minus C. Look at this. There is no change in this row and in this row. R2 and R3, we are not going to make any change. There is only change in this. Look at this, what happens? Minus A, na? A got cancelled, B, B got cancelled, C, C got cancelled. So this element became 0. Over here, look at this, minus B, B, A minus A, C minus A. This also became 0. Minus A, A, minus B, B, C and C. This got cancelled. Now look at this. In this matrix, sorry, determinant, the first row, all elements are first row. Becoming 0. And then second one is B minus C, C minus A, C minus A, A minus B, A minus B, B minus C. So we, by using this property, we are able to convert the elements of first row into 0. And then you can say, by using the second property which says, if all elements of any row or column are 0, then the value of determinant becomes 0, and this is what is your right hand side. So just by using properties, look at this, we have not expanded anywhere. Just by using properties, we have arrived to the result. We got the right hand side. Let's take up one more question. So these questions, what we are practicing, remember that here we can do only couple of questions, but I'll request you all, please solve as many as sums possible from NCERT textbook and your reference book. Keep solving. Now there is another question which I am taking. And again, the condition remains same. It says, prove that, the question is, this is delta given by 1, 1, 1, BC, CA, AB, and over here it is AB plus C, BA plus C, CA plus B. CA plus B. Okay. Now see, question says prove that this determinant is equal to 0. And again, the condition is same. It says that prove this without expanding. What does it mean? You cannot expand. In other way, you have to use only properties. So by using properties, you have to prove this thing. Now look at this question very carefully. What is given? If you look at this, this is BC, CA, AB, and here they are simply A multiplied by sum of B plus C. Can we do one thing? Just open this bracket first and then see what happens. So first thing, write down your question. I have written left hand side as it is without making any change. This is BC, CA, AB, A, B plus C. This is B, A plus C, and last one C, A plus B. Now, after this, what will you do? I'm just simply opening the bracket. So now we are not doing anything. So simply opening the bracket, so it will become 1, 1, 1, BC, CA, AB. Look at this. We are not doing anything. Just simply opening the bracket. So open that. What will happen? It will give you CA plus, it will become BC. Here it will give you AB plus AC. And here you will get, 1 minute. You are getting here AB, AB plus AC. This will give you AB plus BC. And here you will get AC plus BC. This is what is your after opening the bracket. Now, listen, I want to make a small change using property. What is the change? Again, I am going to use invariance property. Look at this. Again, I am utilizing that property. This is what I said. It's very, very important property. And in most of the question, you will see that we are heavily using this property. Look at this. What we are going to do? We are making change in R3. Sorry, we are making change in C3. This is your third column. We are making change in C3, third column. What is the change we are making? We are simply adding in C3 elements of C2. Simply we are adding that. So add this. So what will happen after adding? You can see that 1, 1, 1, this will remain as it is, BC, CA, AB, and then when we are adding, so now there is a change in C3, means the elements of C3 will change. After changing, what will be the elements presentation? Now see that in this case it will become AB plus BC plus AC. I have simply added this. Here also you will get same thing, AB plus BC plus AC, and here also you will get AB plus BC plus AC. You will get the same elements, correct? Now in third column, if you see, all elements are same. Can I take this common outside? If you take common outside, what will happen? AB plus BC plus CA I have taken out from third column. Fine. So what is left? Look at this. Here 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This will remain as it is, BC, CA, AB. You have taken all these. So what is left? 1, 1, 1. Look at this. C1 and C3. Elements of C1 and elements of C3 are becoming identical. They are becoming identical. And when elements are becoming identical, what happens? Determinant becomes 0. Now we are using this property. So using these two properties, we are able to establish the result. This becomes 0, 0 multiplied by this, therefore 0, and hence we are able to achieve the result. Okay, so I have just taken two questions where without expanding, we got the result. Now let's take up some other question where we will be using property as per the need, but at the same time we can expand also because we are not given the condition where it says without expanding. If it is not given, then how to solve? Look at this. So the next question is slightly different, where we have both options. First option, using properties as well as the option which is available of expanding the determinant. Both options are available. So the question which is given, it says prove that minus a square a b a c, then b a minus b square b c, then c a c b, and then minus c square. It says prove that this is equal to 4 a square b square c square. This is what we have to prove. Now to prove, what we have to do? First write down left hand side. So your left hand side is given as minus a square b a c a b a c minus b square b c c b minus c square. This is what is given. Now look at very carefully. We can do something from here. What we are supposed to do? Look at this. From the row 1, look at this. It is written a square. It is written a b. And over here it is written a c. Can we take a common from here? Be very careful. If you take a common, what will happen? A will come outside. So a, I have taken common from here. So what is left after that? So it will become minus a, here it is b, and then over here c is left. I hope you are getting that. We have taken a common from here, so we are getting from first row, from where we have taken this common, change we have brought r1, there is a change. In r1, what is the change? We are writing 1 by a times r1. All elements of this row are divided by a. So a will come outside, that is what is written. Fine. Now similarly, from here if you see, what is it that we can take common? Look at this, b b b, same way we can do that. So from here we can take out a, b also we can take out. So if you take out b, what is left? Again a, here it is minus b, here it is c is left. So what we have done in r2, we have divided by b, r2, and b is taken outside. In same way, in the last row if you see, c is common, I have taken c common. So what is left? A, then over here b, and the last c. So what is the change? In r3 we are dividing by c. So we are dividing, we are multiplying also, so that the approach gets neutralized. So ABC we have got outside. Now this is what is left. Now see that. You may ask that why we have taken a first common from row 1, from b, this element b from row 2, and c from third row. Why we have done? Now see that. By doing this, you can make out that now By taking in this way, it is providing another opportunity to keep something still common. What is that? A you can take on from column 1, B can be taken from column 2, C can be taken common from this third column. This is how otherwise if you have taken first, probably situation would be different. So now proceed further. What will happen? This becomes A, B, C. And now I am taking A, B, C common from here. So if I take common, it will become A square, B square, C square. And then it gives you minus 1, 1, 1, 1 minus 1, 1, 1, 1 minus 1. This is what is left. Please once again understand. I have taken A common from C1. B I am taking common from C2. And C I am taking common from C3. If I take ABC is already given, it will become A square, B square, C square. I hope you are getting that. Now what you have to do? You have to simply expand this. Still if you want to further simplify, one more thing you can do. What? Look at this. From here also you can expand. If you want to simplify further, I would suggest you should simplify. Why? Because then you will realize that the importance of these properties. Look at this, what we are doing. A square, B square, C square, and then what we are doing? The change which we are going to implement in this, I am mentioning over here. In R2, I am making a change. What is that change? In R2, I am adding R2 plus R1. In R2, I am adding this. And then, I am making change in R3 also. What is that change? In R3 also, I am adding R1. So, if I do that, what will happen? A square, B square, C square will remain as it is. So, there is a change in R2, there is a change in R3, but there is no change in R1. So write down first elements of R1, minus 1, 1, 1, written. Now in R2, simply we are adding. So if I add these two, it will become 0. This will become 0. And then if you add, it becomes 2. Now, what is the change in R3? Again, I am going to add with R1. If I add these two, it will become 0. If I add these two, it gives me 2. And if I add these two, it gives me 0. I hope you are getting that. Now see that it becomes very simple if you want to expand. I want to expand this one about first column. Why? Because if I am expanding about this element multiplied by the second order determinant which is left when we are dropping this row and column in which that element belongs to 0. And these two are 0, so whatever will be there, it will become 0. So expand this, it will give you A square, B square, C square, and then minus 1 time, this leave it, it will become 0, 2, 2, 0, and other parts will become 0. So I am writing this as A square, B square, C square, minus 1. And we know that when we multiply top to bottom from left to right, it is positive. This is 0. From left to right, from bottom to top, it is negative. So 2 into 2 is minus 4. It will give you minus 4. And then minus 4 into minus 1, it will give you plus. And hence you are getting 4a square, b square, c square, which is nothing but your right hand side. If you see, this is what you were asked to prove that. This is an important question. It has been asked in your CBSE examination also. Now, I will write one more question. Last question. And this question you will be solving as a part of assignment. Just last question. It says prove that. What you have to prove? It says 1, 1, 1, A, B, C, A square, B square, C square. It says prove that this is equal to A minus B, B minus C, C minus A. This is what you have to prove. and this is I am giving as an assignment to you, but I am giving you a clue how to proceed. By now you might have understood that if you have to expand any determinant, expand the determinant about the row or column which has maximum number of zeros, 1 0 or 2 zeros, because if it is its order is 3 cross 3, if all are zero it will become zero. Okay, but if zeros are not there, you have to look for, is there any way to get zero over here? For example, in this case, if you make the change in R2, what is the change? R2 minus R1. Make the change in R3, what is the change? R3 minus R1. So from this row, if I subtract this, look at this, what will happen? 1 minus 1, 0, this will become 0. From here, if I subtract this, it will become 0. This is 0, this is 0. So in first column, you are getting 2 zeros. So you can expand about this, and when you expand this, you will see that you are getting that result. So, dear students, in today's class, we learned various properties associated with this determinant and how to solve questions based upon it. At times, questions have restrictions. They say that prove this, but without expanding, means by using only properties, and sometimes they say that, oh, using property, expand it, prove that. So both options are available. So assignment related with this is already uploaded, and I would urge to each one of you, please download it, complete, and then send it to me through ERP. In my next lecture, I will be dealing with some other important approaches, how to solve little difficult determinants. So this is what we will be discussing next time. Thank you.